Today I will teach you how to implement FOIL and VOICE algorithm in Mathematica. First of all, I will recap you about the algorithm of VOICE. For the VOICE algorithm, this algorithm for computing the transitive quotient and input will be the adjacency matrix of a digraph, and the output will be the adjacency matrix for show the transitive quotient of the digraph. First, we start with initial value of the adjacency matrix that is represent the graph that you need to computing the transitive quotient, and we in this algorithm it contains G loop. The first loop for create the new matrix, adjacency matrix for each step. I and J is the row and column respectively, and we can compute that each element in the adjacency matrix by use this equation. So for the example in the lecture, I will use this adjacency matrix A, and the transitive quotient of this graph will be the matrix T. First of all, we will declare the variable for represent adjacency matrix of graph. To represent the adjacency matrix of digraph, I need the list, two-dimensional list or array, and each it has a row and column for two-dimensional array, and I use matrix form function for represent array R to in form of matrix. After I press Control and Enter, Shift Enter, it will evaluate the command, and the result will be like this. You can see that the adjacency matrix of the output in Mathematica and the adjacency matrix of the graph in the lecture will be the same. Then we have matrix R like this, and then we will do this equation when K is 1. I don't want to show the value of K after evaluating the code, so I use semicolon to skip the skip showing the output. And you can see this equation. I will use the table function. this function this function will create the list or array in the Mathematica. For example, if I create the list of integer number from 1 to 5, it will be like this. You can see that the array will be shown in the output. For it will have the element from 1 to 5. Or if you want to increase by 0.5, you can add the parameter of the increment or decrement. So in this second parameter of table function, it contains the variable I. It's an index for increment or decrement in the list. And 1 is the start value, 5 is the last value, and 0.5 is the value that increment or decrement in the list. You can see the element in the list will be add or increment by 0.5. This function I will use for it. The next R in this algorithm. I will create Rik and Rkj. I must use bit n. The first one will be Ik. And the second one will be index of k and j. And I need to know the dimension of the array of dimension of the adjacency matrix. So I use length. The length function will return the length or number of element in the list or array. So I use this length. This function to get the dimension of the adjacency matrix, and say that the number of vertices in the graph. And I add a bit or for all the two values. The first one is index ij and the result of n. You look back to the algorithm, you can see that the algorithm will start from index I and then j. So in the table, I will start from the index I. this is outer loop and I add inner loop like this. After run, the result will show in the output 12, and you can see the list of the element in the adjacency matrix, or you can show in the matrix form. You can use matrix form function. You can take parameter R1 to the matrix form function, or you can use R1 and use form like this to apply R1 by using matrix form function like this. The result for using function in the first command and the second command will be the same. The next step, you can change K to and create the matrix R2. It will generate the next step of the Warshaw algorithm. So to generate the first matrix, you can change K equals 3 and create the matrix R3. And so on, the last step will be change K equals 4 and R and create R4. After run this code, you can see that the result will be wrong. Can you guess why the result will be wrong? At the first step, I create the matrix R1. I use the matrix R that is the original of the adjacency matrix. But in the second step, I create a matrix R2, but I will use the original matrix. So the result will be wrong after because I didn't change the variable like variable R to R1. So I will use matrix R only, and I will show the matrix in each step. You can see that the C will the node C over vertex C will not reach another vertex, and the result of this code will be the right one. And you can see the step two after step by step for using Warshaw algorithm. From this code, I will create in the function. I use Warshaw. I create the Warshaw function, and the input of the Warshaw algorithm will be the adjacency matrix. Then to define the function, the custom functions, you can use colon and equal to define the custom function, and then you can copy the operation in the algorithm to the Warshaw function. You can see the color of the function, this function. If the function is not known in the interpreter, it will be show the blue color. If the function is known or in the library of Omega, will be show in the black color. So the Warshaw will be the program will not the Warshaw, the Warshaw name. And we need to change them to length. Length R. After running the washout, the program will know the washout function that I create. And I try to I to test this function, and you can see the matrix. The matrix output will be same as you can see the output will be same as the first step as I learned before, like this. So you can see the variable k. Variable k will be the variable that outside the washout function. What is washout function? Because it is its color is black. If it is a variable in this function, it will be the green one, and the color is light green. So you can add the k will be the second parameter. But in this function, it will create the next step, create the matrix R1 only. So we need another function for create the transitive quotient matrix. I use the table function to create the matrix R1, R2, R3 to Rn, and I call the washout. After use another function to loop the value of k, so you can see the result will not correct. So I can. So to use this is it limited? It's a limit elastic that it cannot create the wash algorithm when using only one function, and you can use like this. To use this this type of the of implement the function, it can only use this function, and you can apply to equation R1 and change to next step like this. It will be the same as the code before, but it will declare in the function. So if you need to complete the algorithm of this for-shell algorithm, so you need another style of creating function. The another style of creating function you can use like this. So you can create the custom function by use colon and equal, then create the module. The module in the Mathematica it is same as the function in the C language, C programming language. The module the module in the Mathematica will contain two parts. The first part is variable declaring. You can declare the variable. You can declare variable in this parenthesis. And the statement will be in the second part. So I will change the input will be A, and I declare the matrix R. So at the first step, R equal A. In the Mathematica, we cannot change anything in the input. We cannot change the value of the input. So we need to copy the value in the input to the another variable. And go back to the algorithm, you can see the next step that we need three loops, T4 loops, and the same operator like before. We need for loop, and we need to add the index variable for three variables. These are I, j, and k. To create a loop, we can use for function like this. The syntax will be the same as the C programming. The first part of the for in this in the Mathematica is to declare the initial value of the index and condition and the stop condition at the second pass and the increment or decrement. I use the comma instead of the semicolon because the for function in Mathematica will take four parameters. It's not like the syntax in the C programming. The C programming will be the statement of the for, and it has four part of statement. The first one to initial value. The second one is the stop criteria, and the third one is increment or decrement, and the last is the the statement or quote in the loop. And I need n for the dimension of the alternancy matrix or the number of nodes in the graph A. Then I need another loop. And then you can copy this code. And this operator will be assigned to matrix R. After calculate the transitive quotient, I need to return the matrix R, so you can use return function like this, or you can call R and you don't type the semicolon. You only type only R, not semi. You don't have semicolon in the next. I forgot one thing, that this operator will compute in each element, so I need to assign each element to. And you can see the result after calling watch algorithm will be like this. It is the same as the result in the lecture. You can change and use return. The result will be the same. You can use R only, or you can use return R to return the value of R. Next, we will implement the Floyd algorithm. The Floyd algorithm will be the same as the Warshell, but it will compute the short pair shortest path, and this operator will be changed. In the Warshell, we'll use the bitwise operator, that is an or operator to find the time-sensitive closure. But in the FOI, we will use the additional of distance into vertex and compare the distance in the previous value with the recent value. To create FOI algorithm, the input of the FOI is the weighted matrix W. So I take the W will be the parameter or the input of the FOI algorithm. I use module to create the function of FOI. And the next step, we'll use the matrix D to initial value of the adjacency matrix of graph W. We need to declare variable D and for the number of vertices in the graph W, and then the index for T roof, that is K, I, and J. Then we will initial the adjacency matrix for computing the all pair shortest path in the FOI algorithm. So we assign D is W. You can see. You can see this step in the algorithm of FOI, and then. We find the number of vertices in the W. You can implement implement followed by the algorithm. So we will compute dij by min. This function will return the minimum value of the list. If you want to know how the function is, how the function return or the parameter in the function, what is the parameter in the function? So you can click on the function name, and you can click on the information and the I symbol, or you can press F1 after you click on the name of the function. After you press F1, the detail of the function will be shown in the next window of the Mathematica, and it will explain about how it returns and the detail for the function, and include the example of the function, how to using the function, and the application that the application for using this function. And you can see the list of function below. These are the function that relate to the min function. And you can see the tutorials that for use that the function will be used in the field of study for some mathematical function, ordering in list or numerical function. And back to the FOIL algorithm. We will compare the minimum value of the dij, that is the previous value of dij, and the new of the will be the candidate of the dij, that is dik plus dkj. And then return d. I use the example in the lecture. The agency matrix will be the same as the example in the lecture, and then and then I will call the void function and to find the all pair shorted path of the adjacency matrix W. Have to try infinity. To try infinity, you can press escape first. After you press escape, the three vertical T dot will be shown, and then you type INF. After you type INF, you can see the pop-up window will be shown like this, and then you press escape again. If you change the word INF into the infinity symbol.
It has to be noted here. So sorry to disturb you. It has to be noted here. If you want to solve this problem using the C programming, you cannot use the infinity. You have to use the maximum possible value in integer value or in floating point value. But normally we will deal with the integer. So you have to use max integer that will be defined in the library. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. When you use the C programming to solve this all-pair shorted path by using the FOIL algorithm that Ajahn mentioned, so in the Mathematica, it is convenient to use infinity symbol to tell the program that it is the very large value or the and the highest value that that the program will have or the storage will have. So to move the or simulate the environment of the C programming, I will show you that I will change the infinity into the 999. So I change. I change the value of the infinity to 999, and then I call the FOIL value, the FOIL function again. When you use the C programming, you will declare the adjacency matrix like this. But in the Mathematica, it is convenient to use infinity instead. And if you want to change some value in the element of the matrix or the list, you can use this operator to change the specific value that you want to change. Or you can use the replace all function. And there is graph distance matrix function in the Mathematica that will generate the all pair shorted path matrix. It's meant to be a graph. The graph of the adjacency matrix W will be like this. And the loop it will be zero with zero. And then I will try to use this function. If you have a graph, you can use the graph distance matrix G matrix to compute the all-pair shortest path. This function will use the Ford algorithm to compute the all-pair shortest path. But you can implement the Ford algorithm like this to find the all-pair shortest path matrix. If this all that I teach you how to write the module function in the MathMaker. อาจารย์ครับต้องโชว์อะไรเพิ่มเติมไหมครับI will show you the application of the for algorithm that it will show you the step by step to compute the overhead shortest path. These are the set of input, and each of field will be the element in the adjacency matrix. This n is mean the number of vertices in the graph, and the step will be shown the step how to compute the overhead path. You can see that after step one is the step one will be the result of the step one will be like this, and then the next step. And this is the third step, and the last step will be like this. To implement the application like this, you can study in the MathMaker by using the manipulate function. And you can see that I use the FOIL function for calculate the overhead shortest path matrix. And this is an application that shows the step by step of Warshaw algorithm. This is the adjacency matrix. The check mark is it will be one. This is the initial value of the adjacency matrix after step one will be shown this, and the step two, the next step, and the last step. Will be the result. Result is the same as the previous one that I implement the Warshaw. The or you can see in the lecture, the result will be the same. อาจารย์ครับ